Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room. Panasonic has announced a new camera. It's called the G9. Let's find out what that's about.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Alrighty, Panasonic has announced a brand new camera this morning. It's called the G9. Where does it fit in their camera lineup? Is it the top, way up there? Or is it the bottom, way down here? Is it in the middle? Where is it? Well, I got the answer for you, alright? The answer is, they basically took the GH5, which is what we're shooting on right now, alright? And it's Canon, it's Panasonic's top of the line camera, their flagship camera for cameras for a Panasonic company. So they took that camera, which is got great still pictures, but amazing videos. So they took that camera, they gave it a little bit of a redesign. The new styling is actually really pretty. I think it's terrific. That's in the eyes of the beholder though. You might look at it and go, yuck. But I look at it and go like, wow, that's pretty cool. As a matter of fact, they move the on and off switch from where it normally is, which is over here. This is a GH4, by the way. And they put it down here, which is the same place Nikon uses it. So when you grab the camera on the G9, you can flick it on and off with your finger because it's wrapped around the shutter. I like that. I like that a lot. It's just like one of those no-brain designs. Should have been there all along. Canon doesn't do it, but Nikon does. And now this new G9 does. So if the GH5 is the flagship and it makes great still pictures but amazing videos, then the G9 is almost basically the same camera, new design, okay, but it makes amazing still pictures and great videos. So it's kind of like Sony does, where one camera focuses heavily towards one type of photography and another camera, which is basically the same camera, okay, focuses or is aimed at another area of photography. So the GH5 is aimed at video guys, but it does great pictures. I could shoot weddings with the GH5. It's stunning. So now the G9 comes along and it makes stunning pictures and does great videos. So how did they do that trade-off? All right, so what Panasonic did is on the GH5, which is, hello GH5, I'm shooting on you right now. It's got all these specs for videos. It goes 400 megabits per second. It does 60 frames per second in super high resolutions. I mean, it is hammering the video aspect of it down and still does a great job for still pictures, okay? So comes the new G9. Well, let's go back to the GH5. And the GH5 is $2,000, $1,999.99. So it's like a penny or a dollar off the $2,000 mark, all right? They think they're fooling us with that simple penny, but it's a $2,000 camera. So the G9, how much is that one? That one is a whopping $1,700. Wow, that's at the upper level. However, they have focused it in, targeted to hammer the still pictures. Ouch! Stop doing that! Okay, but anyway, that's what Panasonic did. They took it and it does 20 frames per second. 20 frames per second? Is that a lot? Hello? Yes, it is. It does 20 frames per second in full RAW. And it even has a burst mode where it'll do 60 frames per second. 6-0. I gotta write that down just for my own sake, okay? 60 frames per second in full RAW, or 20 frames per second normally, okay, in full RAW. So we're talking some serious banging out of pictures here. Then they concentrated on the JPEG engine, made the JPEG engine so it makes even better images than the GH5. They gave it the same articulating screen. The viewfinder is a little bit, not lower in quality, but lower in size when you look through it. However, it's adjustable. Have you ever seen an adjustable size viewfinder? It's an electronic viewfinder. It's a mirrorless camera, all right? So it's got some very exciting things. It's $200 cheaper than the, the GH5, which I'm shooting with right now. And it also does that new trick where it'll give you like 80 megapixel pictures. Now, how does it do that from a 20 megapixel camera? It moves the sensor. The sensor, it actually moves the sensor a half a pixel at a time, and then up, for whatever number of times it needs to move it to sew together a picture that winds up being 80 megapixels in size. Wow! All right, now this is not going to be a run-and-gun type feature. This is going to be an on-the-tripod type feature. So all the rest of the stuff is very, very much in line. As a matter of fact, when you go like, well, how much did they dumb down the video? They didn't dumb down the video much at all, to be honest with you. It just doesn't have that new firmware that Panasonic came out with, where it goes into the high, super high cinema levels. But it has what the GH5 came out with originally. In other words, it does 150 150 megabits per second. It does 4K. Hello, Canon! Panasonic does 4K. So basically, you know what this is? This is a camera that would be, if the update that you're waiting for the 80D, the Canon 80D, it's got 4K, it's got image stabilization in the sensor, it's got image stabilization in some of the lenses, and when you combine them together, boom! The G9 is claiming, I don't have the camera in hand, so I can't tell you, I'm just reading, I'm telling you what I read. 6.5 stops of image stabilization. So what does that mean when you hear that, when you see that number? 6.5 stops. Oh, how nice. What does it mean? I don't know. But it sounds good because the other camera has got 4 stops of image stabilization. And that camera, wow, it's got 5.5 stops, which is what the GH5 has. So this one's got 6.5 stops. Well, can you explain that to me? What does it mean? No, I can't explain it to you. All right, what that means is if the lowest shutter that you can shoot at handheld and not shake, and the picture would come out sharp, is 1/60th of a second of the shutter speed. You can actually start to slow the shutter speed down by 6.5 stops. So it would go from 60 to 30 to 20 to 15. It just keeps going lower and lower. Now, that doesn't affect a moving subject. You can't freeze a guy if he's running, okay? You can't tell the guy, okay, stop, all right? For 6.5 stops. It stops this. When you're nervous and shaky, or some people when they fire a shutter, they don't do it like gently where you don't move the camera, like I'm firing the shutter over and over. They do it like, they like jam it down and it shakes the camera. So that's what 6.5 stops does. It actually fixes your screw-ups up to 6.5 stops. Now, in the normal world, that's a lot. Okay, so that's a very strong feature. So they are hammering all these amazing features. 20 frames per second in RAW, which means you can catch that ball coming right into the pocket, all right? If you're shooting somebody, your kids playing football, you can actually boop, 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 20 frames per second. And if that isn't good enough, so let's say he's actually catching the football, and during that time, he makes a slight grin because he knows he caught that football for the running touchdown. Well, at 60 frames per second, you're going to catch that grin. It's going to be right there in your camera. You just got to go through there and find it. So we're talking big stuff now. So Panasonic is moving into the big league. So where is the negative? If I had to say, if somebody said, Peter, and I would say, yes, and then I'd expect you to say something. So what you would say is, what's the negative here? The negative is, you cannot put gasoline into a diesel engine's gas tank. and you cannot put diesel into a gas car's gas tank. Peter, what are you talking about? Have you lost your mind? Did you take your medicine this morning? Yes, I did. Okay. What I'm trying to say is that it still has a system on the sensor that's called contrast detection focus compared to phase detection focus. One is diesel, one is gasoline, and they don't mix. Now, Panasonic is squeezing. That hurts my knuckles when I do it like that. Anyway, they're squeezing the contrast detection system because that's what they're on, okay? The most out of it. But there's something to the contrast detection system that is a negative. And you can't get rid of it unless you add phase detection into the camera or come up with a brand new system, which is kind of like what Canon did with the dual pixel focus. They took the phase detection, modified it where each pixel is now participating in the focusing. Okay, so what contrast detection does, just by the way it's built, doesn't mean it's a good boy, it doesn't mean it's a bad boy, it just means it's a boy, that's all. So what contrast detection does to arrive at a focus point, so this is our focus point, right where my hand is, okay? So for contrast detection to get to that, it tests. It starts out here, and then it tests here, and they go, okay, let's test a little bit in, and a little bit in, and a little bit in, and then test again, a little bit in, and a little bit in, and then finally, bing, right on the mark, and it's perfectly focused. It's actually the better focus system. Contrast detection is more accurate. However, when you and I see it in action on a video, it looks like it's pulsing. It's going like that, and we don't like that. It's very, it's yuck. It's just not appealing. No way does it fit in any kind of professional work. So if you're trying to look professional, you don't want that pulsing of your focus system. But that's the way contrast detection works. I can't help it. That's the way it works. Phase detection, this is your focus point. So it goes to focus and it's out here somewhere, but it knows it needs to come there. So you know what it does? Boom, it slaps right in. And that's phase detection because it's got a reference point. This is not it. This is it. It joins in. Contrast detection has to test and test. It's never sure. Test and test and test and test. Boom. And then finally, when it does arrive there, it's spot on. Let me tell you, it's very accurate. But we don't want that in our videos. So until Panasonic actually changes the nature of the beast and changes it from being a contrast detection system to something else, preferably a phase detection, or even better, what Canon is doing with their dual pixel focus, they're always going to have that weakness in the video, all right? So they're getting it better and better. The new firmware for the GH5 has gotten better, but it still has that pulsing. If I actually turned on the autofocus on this camera right now, okay, you would see the Christmas lights where the sharp bursts of light right there, they would pulse in and out because it would check the focus every once in a while, where a phase detection system wouldn't do that. And Canon's dual pixel, once it nails my face, if I'm on face detection, it stays put. It's like glued. It's like stuck. Get off. No. Get off. Okay, so that's the type of system that Canon has. Now, Panasonic ain't no little bitty company. It's a big mama, okay? Like Canon is big. As a matter of fact, I think Panasonic's bigger. All right, so eventually they're going to come out with the new type of focus system. But for now, the new G9 has got a contrast detection focus system, just like the GH5 that we're shooting with right now. All right, so that's what the new camera is about. The rest of the camera, everything has gotten improved here and there. They've refined a few things. The JPEG engine, it's supposed to take the best image ever out of a JPEG image, out of Panasonic's camera line forever. And they're making that claim, not me. Don't forget, I haven't had my hands on the camera yet. Hands up, hands off, okay? So until I can get my hands on the camera, I can't tell you that that's true, but that's what they're claiming, and that's a pretty good claim. So I'll put the link to it. You can actually pre-order it if you want to get on the list, but I'll put the link to it on the B&H site directly under the video. Now, when you go there, you can see the specs. You can see comments. You can see the pricing, of course. But the most important thing, like I said, you can actually see and read what the specs are on this camera. So that's about it. So that's it. That's the new camera. It's exciting. And I wanted to bring it to you live from the Christmas room because right now I am live. Okay. All right. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Catch you later. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.